Running through the six on my toes. Oh, wait a minute. Running through the six on my toes. You know how that shit gross. You know how that shit gross. Said running through the six on my toes. You know how that shit gross. You know how that shit gross. Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's April 2nd, dude. It's Friday. It's a good Friday. Thank God it's Friday. Seriously, it's Good Friday, dude. Right? It's a good Friday. Good Friday. Welcome back, everybody. Glad you made it. It's another So-So production. We're doing another sesh. It's Friday, kicking butt, taking names, ladies and gents. Thank you guys for coming in every week, joining me here. If it's your first day, go ahead and catch up on all the videos and all the contentees that I've been making for you guys, dude. Collaborative efforts, things that we've been doing together, this, that, and the other. There's so much goodness and whatever stuff out there. Make yourself feel good. Watch some videos, dude, or something. And then go out there and do something positive for yourself. But if you like these videos, go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Subscribe on YouTube by searching Rob Sadri. Over there, you'll get the full-length videos. I know. You're like, why should I go to YouTube? Well, for the time being, Instagram doesn't allow me because I don't have, you know, X amount of followers to upload the hour-length videos or half-an-hour-length videos. So I have to do it in 10-minute pieces for you guys. But it's all right. Baby steps. We'll get there one day or not. Who cares? It doesn't matter. The point is that I'm trying to get the content out to you. And if you want to get that full-length video, you can go ahead and search Rob Sadri on YouTube and find the videos, baby. I'm going to do a little bit of work for you guys, but I'm going to leave a little bit of the research on your behalf. So if you're interested, go ahead and do it. And if you want to follow your boy and support your boy in any shape or form, go ahead and follow me by clicking that link below my name on the Instagram page. Direct yourself to Patreon, dude, and sign up and let me know what you guys think. I'm still learning, you guys. Maybe it needs a little bit of tweaking. Maybe it needs a little bit of adjustment. It definitely needs adjustment, dude. I'm working on it, guys. Let me get it. You know what? Hold on a sec. I just need to get a sip of this coffee. And also, you're like, Rob, we never see you eat. Dude, do you eat anything? I'm eating, guys. I'm constantly munching. One of my favorite things to eat, actually, I'm not going to eat the whole thing in front of you, but, dude, Nutella, dog. Nutella in any shape of bread or form. Now, mind you, bread, it has to be yesterday. My brother brought me some homemade bread that was excellent. You know what I mean? And every other time I'm going out there, I'm trying to get, you know, I don't want to just get white bread, so I get the bread with the ancient grains, dude. If I'm eating grains, dog, I'm making sure it's ancient. I'm not eating any retro or whatever. I'm not eating anything like, you know, I'm not eating any new grains. I'll tell you that. My grains, ancient, dog. That's how you get the goodness. And that's what that is. This is a little bit of Nutella. With the ancient grains. And they're like, don't eat on camera. That's rude. If you eat on camera with your mouth full and you're eating and you're slurping. I say F it. Have fun with it. Oh yeah. Dude, Nutella on a bagel, dog? Get out of here. Oh, and that black coffee. Thank you very much, dude. I'm grateful for the little things. You know what I mean? Coffee, Nutella, ancient stuff, health, family, you know? Everything. Health, family, my loved ones. You guys are part of the family. I love you guys. Thank you very much. Again, it's a collaborative effort, man. Every day we get in here. Not every day. Every other day, pretty much. Get in here and try to have a little bit of fun, make sense of this, that, and the other together, you guys. Just thinking, what am I doing? I guess this is kind of like it's not a vlog, it's not a podcast, maybe it's not and it's like, it's got hints of comedy in it, so maybe I'm thinking of, you know, if you combine vlogging and comedy, what do you get, boys and girls? What do you get? Bing, bang, boom, clogging, dude. Do some clogging. That's what I've been doing online. Doing some online clogging, dude. It's the only kind of clogging I want. You know what I mean? But, you know, you end up with some other clogging, you deal with it. That's life. Get the plunger. Flush, flush. Man, oh man. You guys, I want to share a couple of videos with you guys. And then we'll just, you know, we'll go and keep things loosey-goosey as per usual. But I wanted to share a couple of videos with you guys and we'll talk about it. Let's just jump right into it. This bad boy right here. Hook it up to the telly, dude. April Fool's prank gets serious after police used water cannon and tear gas to disperse, dude. This was a crowd that gathered in Belgium, and they just had enough of that. Look at this. Bring out the hose, dude, and not the good kinds either. You know what I'm saying? People gathering, sirens are going, and police, men and women are now trying to ride horses and wrangle people, dude. You know what I mean? It's just, it doesn't make sense to me anymore at this point, because, like, man, it's just innocent people gathering in the park because it's been a year, man. You can't just, it's prison, dude. It feels like prison. I'm not saying anything, but this is what happened in Belgium. Look at these youths, or youths, depending on how you want to say it. 16-year-old wants to get out there and live life, dude. Wants to get out there and live life. And there's some police officers who are also wanting to get out there and live their lives. They don't want to be doing this stuff, but that's their job. You know, you signed up for that and they're like, today you're gonna go, you know, give this lady a hard time. She just wants to live her life. That's what she's saying, dude. That's what she's saying. Look at that. It's so wild. There's literally people getting hosed. There's some people taking selfies. There's some people just like dancing. I don't even know what to make of this, but this is where we're at. I mean, yeah, good times. Good times. Let's pause that for a second. And that's what that is, man. That's what that is. You know, it's April Fool's yesterday. I guess some people in Belgium decided to, you know, go out there and just, you know, be fooling around with nature and themselves a little bit, because everybody needs to get out, man. You can't just, like, you know, have you ever, yeah, I feel like a lot of us, especially I feel bad for the kids, these, dude. You need to be, like, getting rid of that energy, going around, making friends, learning how to socialize. Kids already had a hard time with, like, these things in the first place. I think every generation, well, that's the thing. Socializing is a part of your childhood. You learn these things, and for it to be interrupted for a year, forget about the schooling right now, dude. We just went under, like, I don't even know what's happening. I'm reading more articles online that schools are going to just be getting ready to do online learning, and blows my mind, dude. Blows my mind, because some of the families, you know, if you can afford it, it'd be nice. Maybe you could do it at home with your kids, teach them a little something, have the facilities, give them their nice little room with their laptops and their iPads and this, that, and the other, and get them a tutor if need be, get a tight circle. But sometimes most parents don't have all the access to all the amenities, and it just makes it a little bit difficult, right? And that's when you start, you know, seeing again cases of domestic abuse, violence against children being on the rise and stuff like that. It's just, you know, it's weird. And I don't know what to think of it. I don't know what to make of it. It's just like, you know, you don't want to be, I don't want to be fighting with cops. I don't want anybody going out there getting hosed down and like tasered and lasered or whatever. And like, but that's the thing. At one point, like, where do we draw the line with enough is enough, bro? Enough is enough. Especially it's like spring and summer. I think the best thing is, like, I think people should be getting exercise, going out for walks, staying out in the sun. But up there in Belgium, it just seems like you'll get hosed down, dude. And that's alarming, dude. That's alarming. I mean, this is a very slippery slope. We need to be talking about these things, and we need to actually take action. And I don't know what the right action is, dude. I don't know anymore. It's do we all just like, I'm just throwing out ideas. Instead of protesting, what if everybody were to just be like, you know what, I'll open up shop. I'm just throwing out ideas. I'll just open up shop and take the fines that they give me and then do a class action lawsuit if that's, you know, get some lawyers thinking about this kind of stuff. I don't know, man. Because this just paves the way for just richer people to move in. Because smaller businesses, mom and pops who can't pay their bills, they'll get shut down, they'll get closed down, and we'll see a ton of that happening. And then that'll just pave the way. They'll gentrify, they'll get gentrified, they'll have to move out of the city core. You know, folks with a little bit of capital or more capital are gonna move in buying the spots, and this just adds to the cycle of inflation that's never ending. You know what I mean? And right now, Toronto, dude, a lot of places globally, dog. I've been having my eye out on things for some time. Globally speaking, there are a lot of housing markets, dude, that are bubbling. It's about to burst sometime. Thing is, nobody knows when, but we do feel it when you hear of a single garage in Toronto going up for sale for 730. That's right, when you hear a single garage going up for sale for 730,000 Canadian doll hairs, dude, that's when you know things are out of line or something. There's an imbalance, is what I'm trying to say. And that's what it is. But you know what? It's not always. I do want to share a little bit of good news too. It's not always sad shit. Not that this is, again, life's just somewhere in between all the time. It's best of times, worst of times, and we got to just make sense of it together. But I want to show you guys this heartwarming story of an officer who found a toddler lost in Ontario woods, and he calls him a little tough guy, dude. So this little man, so this kid, he went off to the woods, man. He went off to the woods and he went missing for 3 days, dog. 3 days, this little kid went missing. And let's just watch it and see what happened.
Survival is unbelievable.
It's just amazing he survived. I don't even know if I would have lived for that long.
Seriously.
On Sunday, 3-year-old Jude Layton went missing here. Police and volunteer crews combed woods and water day and night at times.
Well, let's pause that for a second. Are you guys with me here? 3 days as a toddler being lost in the woods, and this kid doesn't have what seems, thank God, like he doesn't seem to have a scratch on him, dude. This kid's a superhero or something, dog. Or maybe the aliens took him and did, like, you know, gave him superpowers or something. But the thing is, I mean, I've been lost when I was a kid for, I'm still lost, dude. But the thing is, I got lost a few times when I was a kid, but for very short periods of times. Do you know what I'm talking about? One time, I think we were just like walking around with my moms. I was licking my ice cream cone. Licking, licking. I let go of mom's hands and just like, you know, do a little turnaround and then grab somebody else's hand, thought they were my mom, and just like walk with them for a good 5 minutes and then look up and, man, it's not mom's. That's alarming that the elder person didn't say anything either. But shit happens. Jokes. But seriously, let's watch the rest of this for a second, because it is heartwarming and you don't hear enough of this.
The temperatures were below freezing.
Below freezing. Not above, dude.
Area.
Below.
If you wander off, you know, you can, it's quite easy to get lost. Even I've been turned around.
Look at these lands, dude. Look at this.
From Sunday all the way to Wednesday, this clearing that's empty now was full with people, with vehicles, fishermen.
Mad.
Two helicopters landed here until the best moment on Wednesday when through that clearing.
This is on Global News, you guys.
On an ATV.
Global National.
That's the best day I've had to be in 25 years.
It was Constable Scott McName's birthday when he got the call to help. He searched for 3 days.
It was rocky, it was steep.
Man, that's nuts.
I do not think that a 3-year-old, almost 4-year-old, would be able to get that.
Constable Scott, dude, doing
less
it.
Less than a kilometer from the family compound, McName spotted something blue. Another officer ran up ahead.
He said, he's here. He was lying down.
All right. Sweet, you get the gist of it. Point of this story was to share a little bit of goodness, because we don't get enough of that. Good vibe news, you know what I mean? It's always something terrible's going down, and It's gonna get worse, and it's just gonna continue to get worse, and then tomorrow you'll be hit with something else too. But it's nice to at least get a little bit of, you know, attention on the positives. Dude, this kid went out, I don't know what for, but he went out for a hike. And you're a toddler, dude, you're going out for hikes. Good on you, active kid. Kid's gonna be a runner, you know it. But I'm glad he's safe. I'm glad there is, you know, good men and women out there doing positive things, and sometimes you end up with positive results. Nothing for the most part seemed to have happened to him, you know, obviously getting exposed to the conditions. Again, I don't know how he made it, because if it was your boy dude out there just like wandering around, if I got lost, bro, I don't know if I would have made it to 72 hours. So good on you for the kid to being, you know, he kept his jacket on apparently, boots on, shoes on, so everything. So that's smart, bro. That's smart. Good on you, but also like watch your kids. It's just, you know, it's just, how do we, you're like, Rob, how do we get to, you know, how do we stop being a little bit judgmental? And I don't know why you're asking me that. I don't know why you're asking, but if you're asking me that, I tell you to maybe try walking in somebody else's shoes for a little while. And you're like, man, how do I walk in somebody else's shoes, bro? Well, first of all, you'd want to have the intention of wanting to walk in somebody else's shoes, and then you go out there and, you know, it starts by borrowing. You gotta ask a couple of peeps, can I borrow your shoes? And then they'll be like, what do you want my shoes for? Come up with an excuse, dog. Don't seem like a creep out there asking for shoes, but put out what you want on the table. Let the man or woman know that you'd like to take a few steps, and if they don't give it to you, move on, dude, move on. Next time, you know, that's steal a pair of shoes. The point is, don't steal shoes. The point is, try to, like, you know, think about what it means to be another person for a few seconds, going through their role. I actually like that activity because it's easy to contemplate life from my point of view and your point of view when we're just, you know, in the bods and the meat bods and the head bods and the minds and the individual and this stuff. But, like, I find it really interesting. I've always done that ever since I was a kid. I've always thought about, man, what does it feel like, really? And like, try to, like, what does it feel like to be another, like, this spirit or another spirit in another body? And I would just, like, look at people. I'm just trying to contemplate what they're going through. And it's, like, amazing, man. You just, like, and you can make up a story. Just, like, you know, you look at their outfit and you can make up a story. Doesn't even matter, but, you know, as long as you try to place yourself in somebody else's shoes for a second. So that way, I don't know, maybe we could use our common sense and just be nicer to each other so that we're not, you know, using hoes to, like, push each other out the way just for wanting to get out there and enjoy some sunshine, dude. You know what I mean? All in all, I'm very optimistic, you guys. I think we're making progress. We are getting more news, you guys. We're getting more news. More lockdowns. I don't even, it's just like, so here's the thing, they've been going this, they're like, now it's, this is the third wave, dude. The third wave. The third wave, they said. So is this the last wave, dude? Is this the last wave? Because waves come in three. I don't know if you guys know anything about waves, but like back in the day when I was growing up, they always said waves come in threes. I think. So I'm just like, good, let it be the third one. At least maybe this is the last one. Is this the last one, or is this gonna, you know, perpetuate into the fourth wave, dude? Because, like, you know, spring break late edition, dude, you know, kind of like, you know, when you're anticipating your favorite artist to drop some new songs or an album, they're like, it's, we're working on it, it'll be the end of this month, and you're like, it still didn't come, and then it'll just like linger on. And but that's the thing, is this gonna be, maybe COVID will drop a new hit on us in fall or winter again. I don't know. Definitely have not heard anything about the new release dates, but it's just like, how many waves are we gonna get? How many zones do we have? I don't even know. Like, to me, I've just been living my life very much the same, more. Like, I've been obviously a little bit more careful, this, that, and the other, but most of that is just optics for the peepsies out there. Regularly, for my own sake, I could care less, dude. I don't care. I'll drop food on the table and I'll just like lick it off. And if it's on the table and it's clean, sometimes I'll on purpose drop it on the floor, eat that bad boy up to work up my immune system. That's just the way I work. But to each their own. This is just purely for your entertainment purposes only, or something, dude. But that's life. That's life, boys and girls. Yeah, try to just, you know, take a couple of steps. And again, it starts by borrowing shoes, stealing shoes. And make sure, you know, make sure you're taking a few steps in other people's shoes sometimes, so that, you know, I don't even, like, I feel bad for everybody right now. It's because, like, you see the youth, like, wanting to get out there, and then you see the cops who are pretty much, like, you know, a little bit older than these guys, just, like, with a water cannon. Meh. Meh. Squirt, squirt. Meh. Pew, pew. Meh. Go stay home. Meh. Wear a mask. Meh. Or something. I don't know. That's how... That's how the cops sound in my head. Meh. Wear a mask, meh. But not all cops do that, dude. Constable Scott, a few seconds ago, he was out there taking care of business, what actually needs to get done, rescuing people, providing, you know, a service of, you know, being helpful. There are a ton of good police officers out there doing good things, too, but it's just right now we're going to be in this stage where we're going to be, like, pitted against each other, and it's just, like, forget about the uniforms, but underneath it all is just humans, right? So it's like some humans are saying, man, we want our freedoms back. We like to go out there and just live because tomorrow's not promised. And, you know, a lot of people have been cooped up. And some of you guys, you know, have lost family members, again, directly or indirectly because of COVID, man. You know what I was hearing the other day, which was alarming? Somebody blew the whistle, dog. Somebody blew the whistle on this elderly's, like, you know, I forget the term, you know, the old folks home. Somebody blew the whistle on one of these places, and what they'd done, I hate that term, I don't mean to, but whatever, man, you know what I mean. The long-term care homes or whatever, like, you know what I'm talking about, dude. Places where peepsies go, individuals, where it's a community for the elderly individuals with other elderly individuals, and they gather there and they just, you know, play chess, break a couple of hips, doing the dirty sometimes. And forget about that. The part that I'm trying to talk about is these folks were locked inside their rooms, and the handlebars of their rooms were removed so that they don't go outside, dude, so that they don't contaminate other people, or they don't get contaminated by the... What are we doing here, dude? What are we doing? You were getting rid of handlebars on the elderly, dude? If you want to take anything, I mean, some folks, dude, if you're pushing 99 and if you're still driving, maybe don't be driving, dude, but I think you can handle a knob, dog. Tell you what, bro, if I'm 99 and you see me behind the wheel, let it be a pretend wheel, dude, like Maggie Simpson. You know what I'm talking about? If I'm 99 pushing 100, I want it to just be pretend driving. That's aside the case, and this is not a case of ageism. This is a case of people losing their marbles. Dude, you're removing handlebars off of doors so that people can't leave. This is, you're putting people in prison, dog. You're putting people in prison, dude. This is scary stuff. This is weird stuff. This is how, you know, don't ever do that to people. Don't lock anybody in any place, dude. Let people get out there. Don't lock people up. People are not animals. Animals are not animals. Animals are spiritual things too. Spiritual animals and creatures. You know what I'm talking about, dude. Don't lock things up. Don't lock people up. Don't lock animals up. Pets are a different story, I guess. Point is, sharing is caring. Step in another person's shoes. Be grateful. Be mindful. Be thankful. Be nice to each other. Be nice to yourselves. And we'll get through this, whatever this is, boys and girls. I love you very much. Thank you for all your love and support, ladies and gents. We're going to be back here tomorrow for the Patreon episode. If you like these videos, go ahead and like them on Instagram. Follow me on YouTube. Click the link below my name on Instagram. Follow me on Patreon. Support your boy, and I'll be able to support you guys in however ways I can, dude. That's the thing. I'm trying to give back whatever it is, whether it's tickling your brains from a far variety internets, dude, or just, you know, talking about issues that are of concern to me, and I believe that are of concern to you as well. And nobody's got the answers, but together, by asking questions, by poking fun at ourselves, by poking fun at each other's little inconsistencies, and not to make anybody sound like the bad guy or the good guy, dude. We're all in it together. I'm not. Yeah, this guy's just trying to figure it out, and I want everybody to be like, you know, man, I know sometimes it's just like, I honestly just want people to be happy and healthy and have access to resources and amenities and making their best version of themselves. That's what I want. And sometimes it feels like they're little impediments or sometimes large impediments. But I want everybody to calm down. I want everybody to relax. Please don't let the times get the best of you. If you're under any sort of pressure, talk to somebody, if whether it's financial, mental health concern, physical. We all are in need of help and support from each other. Go out there, find things that are beneficial to you. If your little brain needs a little bit of tweaking, you know what I'm talking about, get that electroshock therapy. Jokes, but talk to somebody, all right? If you're obese, go exercise. If you're suffering from respiratory issues, work on it, get some help. Don't blame other people. If you're living life and all's gooch, good on you, bro. Share the goodness with everybody else too. You know what I'm saying? And that's it, boys and girls. I'll talk to you all very soon. I love you very much. Thank you for, again, all the love and support and being a part of this journey and letting me be a part of yours, man. I'll talk to you all very soon. Keep it breezy out there, boys and girls. Peace out.